And assalamu alaikum and a very good evening to all of our participants over here today, all the attendees at this wonderful initiative by the ACCA titled KP, Pakistan's Gateway to Economic Prosperity. There's absolutely no doubt how far we have come across, you know, as a province in terms of, you know, development. And when you talk about development, development is not just in one particular sector. It is in academia. It is in the transformation through the entrepreneurial ecosystem that has actually not only prevailed but has mushroomed and grown in Peshawar and in KP in general. Other than that, in the banking industry, in the banking sector, and the political landscape for that matter as well. And today's panel discussion is actually very interesting because we would be highlighting and touching base on diversity and inclusion in all of these sectors, in all of these spaces, through entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship is something that is driving the workforce, the workplace of our economy. And a very recent report by Google, published on Think with Google, actually said that 90% of the country is actually driven by SMEs, which is actually a very, very big number for that matter. So we have some very prominent people sitting over here, and I'd like this to be a very, very engaging dialogue. We'll be happy to take in questions from the audience as well. I would like to start with Faisal, you know, he's sitting right across on the other side. Faisal, you have been involved with the National Incubation Centers, both in Karachi as well as the NIC over here in Peshawar. And when you talk about a good business, you just don't talk about a good go-to-market strategy. It's also about the outreach. How are the NICs facilitating outreach and support to all? And when you say all, it's all about inclusion, right?
Thank you, Mariam, and thank you, everyone, for coming over here. So I'm lucky that I'm managing two NICs at the south end of the country and at the north end of the country. So these incubation centers, whether they're the local ones over here or the one all across the country, they play a very important role in the fact. Inclusive entrepreneurship is basically just about two things, that whoever you are, regardless of your gender, regardless of your religion, regardless of your age, whether you're unemployed, you're a professional existing businessman, whoever you are and wherever you are, in the main metropolitan city or in a village or up somewhere in the mountains. These incubation centers are there to provide you support. If you want to start a business, these centers are there to support you. Primarily around three things, providing the pre-support that requires to set up a business, providing access to all the mentors and coaches that you need along the journey, and of course, providing you access to funds. So yes, incubation centers provide a very important role in the inclusive entrepreneurial ecosystem.
When you talk about outreach, you know, another great thing that comes to my mind, and I'll pass this on to the academia right now. We have two people from the academia over here. So the question is addressed for you both. We've seen that schools at this point in time, and I'll talk about both our private sector and also our government sector. We've seen that there are multiple new initiatives by the government, but hailing from academia, number one, my first question to you would be, how far do you see a shift in academia from churning A graders in schools towards incorporating and ensuring that it's skill-based learning, ensuring that there's inclusion for all, you know, in terms of, because everybody is differently able, differently skilled for that matter. Whoever would like to go first.
Okay. Assalamu alaikum, everybody. Thank you for inviting me. And thank you, Asad, as well for inviting me. And it is a privilege to be part of this this gathering. Well, the question that you said that we have to shift students from A graders to the skill-based learning as the first discussion took place on the IT and the technology. So obviously, as more economic development goes on, so there will be demand for more skill-based jobs, obviously. And that discussion also took place that we have to bring people, like technology cannot replace humans. So the old jobs has to be lost. That is for sure. But there will be creation of new jobs, certainly. So we will have to bring students from just pure academia to the skills-based, like accountancy professions. We have to spend in professions, obviously, in order to bring our human capital at par, because it's not just the human number that we have. Like in our KP, obviously, we have a human number, but it's not the human number that counts. The quality of the labor counts in the modern world, obviously. So it's not only the human capital, but the intellectual capital that has to be developed in order for the economy to grow, because the economic growth will have a lot of factors that are involved, and all of those factors have to be in harmony. You cannot develop one side and then expect economic growth to happen. So all of the factors have to work in harmony to actually have the economic growth.
For me, जब हम बात कर रहे होते हैं स्किल्स डेवलप करने की, तो सबसे पहले तो देखें जो क्वालिफिकेशन है उसके सिलेबस, उसके कोर्स कंटेंट को देखना होगा. अगर आप ACCA की प्योरली बात करते हैं, क्योंकि हम उस एकेडमिक सेक्टर से आ रहे हैं, सो जैसे आपकी मॉडर्न इकोनॉमीज इवेल्यूएट कर रही हैं, इवॉल्व हो रही हैं, जैसे नई टेक्नोलॉजीज आ रही हैं, सो हमने उन्हीं नई टेक्नोलॉजीज को अपने सिलेबस का हिस्सा बना लिया. जैसे अभी आजकल का सबसे बेहतरीन टॉपिक चल रहा है, डेटा एनालिटिक्स पे चल रहा है. सो डेटा एनालिटिक्स आपके सिलेबस का हिस्सा बन चुका है. सेकेंडली, हम लोगों ने जो हमारा एजुकेशन स्ट्रक्चर है, स्पेशली ACCA की अगर हम बात करते हैं, मैं अपने एकेडमिक इंस्टीट्यूट की बात करूँ, वो काफ़ी इवॉल्व हो चुका है. हम लोग सिर्फ बच्चे को एकेडमिक साइड पे नहीं लेके जा रहे, बल्कि उसकी एकेडमिक पढ़ाई के अंदर ही रहते हुए उसे प्रैक्टिकल एक्सपोजर भी मिल रहा है. वो प्रैक्टिकल एक्सपोजर उसी से मिल रहा है कि बीन सिमुलेशन नाम से एक सॉफ्टवेयर लाया गया, जिसमें आप प्रैक्टिकली क्लास के अंदर बच्चे को बता रहे हैं कि अब आपने ऑडिट कैसे करना है. आप जो ACCA के एग्जामिनेशन है वो कंप्यूटर बेस्ड हैं सारे. उस बच्चे को पढ़ाया कंप्यूटर के थ्रू जाता है, उसको टेस्ट कंप्यूटर के थ्रू किया जाता है, उसकी एग्जामिनेशन थ्रू आउट कंप्यूटर के थ्रू हो रही है. सो डेफिनेटली वो जो पुराने अकाउंटेंट्स हैं उनसे इनके जो कंप्यूटर स्किल्स हैं वो फार मोर बेटर हैं उन पुराने अकाउंटेंट से. और वो जब मार्केट में अब जा रहे हैं तो उन्हें बेसिक कंप्यूटर की नो हाउ भी है, बेसिक स्किल्स भी हैं कंप्यूटर के, साथ ही साथ वो टेक्नोलॉजी से वेल इक्विप्ड हैं. जो बेसिक टूल्स ऑफिसेज में यूज़ हो रहे हैं वो अपने एकेडमिक साइड पे ही पूरे करके जा रहे हैं. सो इस तरह जो चेंज मैनेजमेंट का प्रोसेस है वो एकदम तो नहीं आ सकता, लेकिन अगेन इस साइड से गवर्नमेंट की सपोर्ट कुछ नहीं. अगर आप पब्लिक सेक्टर को देखें, वहाँ से कोई सपोर्ट नहीं. ACCA अपने पार्ट पे तो कर रहा है, कॉलेजेस अपने पार्ट पे तो कर रहे हैं, लेकिन अगर आप स्किल्स डेवलप करने की बात करें, हमारे पास जब बच्चा आता है वो आ रहा है एक बेसिकली जो आपके एलिमेंट्री एजुकेशन है, सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन है, हायर एजुकेशन है, उसमें इतनी डिस्पैरिटी है. आपके कुछ बच्चे जो गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज से आते हैं वो शायद कंप्यूटर चलाना ही नहीं जानते. हमारे पास बच्चा आता है उसे यही नहीं पता होता कंप्यूटर ने ऑन कहाँ से होना. जब आप उस बच्चे को लेके चलते हैं, फिर हम उसके लिए कोर्सेज डिज़ाइन करते हैं, शॉर्ट कोर्सेज डिज़ाइन होते हैं, सो दैट वो इतना लिटरेट हो जाए कि उस कंप्यूटर को इस्तेमाल कर सके, उस पर एग्जामिनेशन दे सके. सो जो चेंज मैनेजमेंट है फॉर मी वो ग्रासरूट लेवल से आनी है. इतने ऊपर लेवल पर आके उसको एकदम चेंज कराना ये शायद मुमकिन नहीं है. सो ये जैसे सर ने कहा कि ये सारी बात इंक्लूजन की है, कि अगर हमारा एजुकेशन सिस्टम एज अ होल इंक्लूजन की तरफ जाए, एज अ होल इवॉल्व करेगा, तो फिर जाके स्किल्स का डेवलप हो सकता है. अदर देन जब आप एक कंटेम्प्रेरी अप्रोच को लेके चलेंगे, बच्चा एकेडमिकली बहुत स्ट्रांग हो जाएगा, लेकिन उसमें शायद वो स्किल्स, वो जो बिजनेस एक्यूमेन है वो डेवलप नहीं होता, क्योंकि आपकी जो एकेडमी है वो सिलेबस वही पढ़ाए जा रहे हैं जो पिछले 30-40 साल से पढ़ाए जा रहे हैं, जबकि मॉडर्न वर्ल्ड कहीं से कहीं निकल गई है. सो जो स्किल सेट डेवलप करने की बात है वो मेरे ख्याल से सिर्फ एक एकेडमिक इंस्टीट्यूट या आपकी एक डिग्री आप में नहीं डेवलप कर सकती. उसके लिए आपका जो ग्रास रूट लेवल से लेकर ऊपर तक का एजुकेशन सिस्टम है उसने एज अ होल इवॉल्व होना है, और डेफिनेटली इट विल टेक टाइम. आपका जो सिलेबस मैट्रिक का है, FSC का, ये इवॉल्व होगा, फिर यूनिवर्सिटी लेवल पे आके बच्चे के अंदर स्किल्स डेवलप होंगे.
Thank you, but I'd like to take this point further to the education sector again. We spoke about skills, we spoke about the government has to go hands in hands with the private sector, everybody has to come together, and this aapne jo baat kahi ki this disparity ke ek bachcha hai usko kuch set of skills, usko computer use karna nahi aata, dusre ko use karna aata hai. Lekin jab aap skill set ki baat karte hain to are we more job centric even now? Are we also trying to target towards entrepreneurship? Because we do happen to have public-private partnerships. Taking the NICs for that example, we happen to have the KPIT board very actively involved with the Dushals across the province, taking ideas together. So when you talk about inclusion, it's bringing them all together. So my question to the education people hailing from the academia over here right now is, how are you ensuring potential outreach in terms of entrepreneurship?
मैम, आई वुड लाइक टू एड्रेस इट. देखें, अगर आप बात करती हैं पब्लिक प्राइवेट पार्टनरशिप की, हायर एजुकेशन कमीशन ऑफ पाकिस्तान ने रिसेंटली इनिशिएटिव लिया वेयर दे टारगेटेड 30 यूनिवर्सिटीज लेकिन वो सारी पब्लिक यूनिवर्सिटी थी जिधर उन्होंने बिजनेस इंक्यूबेशन सेंटर्स बनाए, जिसमें 7 यूनिवर्सिटीज केपीके में है और 3 पेशावर में, लेकिन सारी की सारी पब्लिक सेक्टर यूनिवर्सिटीज हैं, कोई भी प्राइवेट यूनिवर्सिटी या प्राइवेट इंस्टीट्यूट नहीं है। सेकेंडली, जब आप बात करते हैं इंक्यूबेशन सेंटर्स की या एंटरप्रेन्योरियल स्किल्स की, तो प्राइवेट सेक्टर ने अपनी फाइनेंशियल रिसोर्सेज को भी देखना है, अपनी कंस्ट्रेंट्स को भी देखना है। एज लॉन्ग एज हम जो कर सकते हैं, हम ये कर सकते हैं कि हम बच्चों के लिए प्रोग्राम्स डिज़ाइन किए, हमने अपने कॉलेज लेवल पे इंडस्ट्रियल विजिट्स कराए बच्चों को, सो दैट वो इंडस्ट्रीज को देखें, वो उनके एंटरप्रेन्योर से मिलें, उनके सीनियर लेवल मैनेजमेंट से मिलें, उनसे सीखें, शायद वो इस तरफ जा सकें। सेकेंडली, हम एंटरप्रेन्योर्स की जब बात करते हैं मैम, आप उनकी एक्सेस टू फाइनेंस को भी तो देखें ना। अगर आप बात करते हैं पाकिस्तान की पोर्टफोलियो की, तो पूरे बैंकिंग पोर्टफोलियो का जो 66% है वो ब्लू चिप कंपनीज को जाता है, सिर्फ 6% आपका SMEs को मिलता है। फिर पाकिस्तान के पूरे बैंकिंग क्रेडिट पोर्टफोलियो का 30% पाकिस्तान की बड़ी कंपनियों को मिलता है, SMEs के पास तो 6% रह जाता है। अगर बच्चे को आप एंटरप्रेन्योरियल साइड पे लाते भी हैं कि आप अपना बिजनेस डेवलप करें, उसको सबसे पहले फाइनेंस चाहिए होता है। अब फाइनेंस की दो ही साइड है, या वो खुद से इन्वेस्ट करेगा या वो डेट फाइनेंसिंग की तरफ चलेगा। अब आपका जो कंटेम्प्रेरी बैंकिंग सिस्टम है, वो डेट फाइनेंसिंग के लिए उसे कोलेट्रल मांगता है, क्रेडिट हिस्ट्री मांगता है, जो कि दोनों उसके पास नहीं होती। फिर उसके पास ऑप्शन रह जाता है कि वो इनफॉर्मल लोनिंग की तरफ जाए। अब इनफॉर्मल लोनिंग बहुत एक्सपेंसिव है, अगेन वो उसका जो टैलेंट है या शायद उसके जो स्किल्स हैं वो दब के रह जाते हैं, और फिर ये डिस्पैरिटी गैप बढ़ता जाता है। हाँ, शायद डिजिटलाइजेशन की तरफ अगर वो बच्चा आए, अगर हम अपने जो बच्चे हैं उनको इस तरफ लेके आए कि जी आप डिजिटल पेमेंट की तरफ जाएं, तो उससे ये हो सकता है 6 महीने साल अगर वो अपना बिजनेस उसी पेमेंट रूट के थ्रू डेवलप करने की कोशिश करते हैं, तो उसकी एक बैंकिंग हिस्ट्री आ जाएगी, एक क्रेडिट हिस्ट्री आ जाएगी। और एक बैंक ने रिसेंटली एक ऐप डेवलप की है स्पेशली इसी पर्पस के लिए, अल्फा नाम है उस ऐप का। उसमें यह है कि अगर कोई ऐसा कॉटेज इंडस्ट्री है, SME है, छोटा बिजनेस है, अगर वो अपनी सारी पेमेंट्स या मेजॉरिटी पेमेंट्स को उसी ऐप के थ्रू करता है, तो उसकी जो फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन का कॉन्सेप्ट है वो बीच में आ जाता है कि सारी उसकी पेमेंट्स उसी ऐप में रिकॉर्ड हो रही होंगी, और थ्रू दैट ऐप वो लोन के लिए भी अप्लाई कर सकता है। उस ऐप में बेसिक पैरामीटर्स डिफाइंड है, कोई ह्यूमन इंटरेक्शन नहीं है। अगर आप उन पैरामीटर्स को पूरा करते हैं, वही ऐप आपको 1 मिलियन तक ओवरड्राफ्ट फैसिलिटी देने को भी तैयार है। लेकिन स्टिल ये बहुत ही प्राइमरी स्टेज पे है, वो ऐप लॉन्च होगी, फिर बाकी बैंक भी इसमें इवॉल्व होंगे, सो इट विल सर्टेनली टेक सम टाइम।
थैंक यू, आई लाइक टू टेक अ पॉइंट फ्रॉम फैसल ऑन दिस।
यस, सो टेकिंग दैट फॉरवर्ड, वी एट NIC व्हाट हैव डन इज दैट वी आर टॉकिंग टू IIM साइंस यूनिवर्सिटी एंड वी आर हेल्पिंग देयर फाइनल ईयर प्रोजेक्ट्स, वी आर हेल्पिंग देम टू सेलेक्ट what kind of project they should go into, so that it should have some commercial sense as well, and it will help the students that once they graduate, they have a fairly high chance of getting into an NIC and take that idea further into the market.
I think that's a brilliant idea. This is exactly what should be happening. A note to all the other universities, work on your FIPs, the final year projects. I think one of the best ideas and the best startups actually emerge out of the FIPs for that matter. You spoke about access to finance, which takes me towards the banking sector over here. And mere do sawal hai aapse. Sabse pehla sawal to mera ye hai, access to finance ki kafi log baat karte hain. Startups actually talk about it all the time. Pioneer ke baare mein bahut baatein hoti hain. But my first question is a very generic one, to give everybody an idea about what is happening, about the valuable inputs that the banking sector is lending in order to ensure inclusion and opportunities for all SMEs and startups for that matter.
Thank you, Mariam. When we look at finance, or when we look at a business, finance becomes an integral part of that setup. And naturally, there are general two elements. The capital from the owner end, then they go to the market, informal sector that they talked of. And when they come to bank, normally speaking, when the business has reasonably grown up, it's the time to go to banking, as we think. But it's not really the case anymore. Banks, they're not the only they do not provide financing only, they also provide an opportunity for hand holding. Aapko bank ko dekhna chahiye as an institution jo ki aapki capacity bhi build karta hai. Aapko financial facilitation ke sath sath aapko market to access access to market ki bhi ek conduit provide karta hai, aur aapko training ki opportunity bhi provide karta hai. For example, humne yahan par बैंक ऑफ खैबर में किया है कि वी डिड अ पायलट प्रोजेक्ट इन चतराल एंड चतराल टिपिकली फार्मर जनरली ओन 3 to 5 प्लांट्स फ्रूट प्लांट्स और इनके लिए पॉसिबल नहीं था कि अपने फ्रूट को प्रॉपरली चैनलाइज करके उनका यील्ड दैट इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ फाइनेंशियल बेनिफिट बढ़ा सकें. हमने वहाँ पर क्या किया कि वी फॉर्म ग्रुप्स ऑफ 10 टू 15 फार्मर्स उनके जो प्लांट्स नेचुरली जो प्रोड्यूस था वो फ्रॉम 5 to 75 प्लांट जब चला गया तो वी ट्रेंड देम ऑन ग्रेडिंग वी ट्रेंड देम ऑन पैकिंग एंड वी देन क्रिएटेड एन अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर देम टू टेक दैट प्रोड्यूस टू मोर सफिस्टिकेटेड और द नियर बाई मार्केट्स एंड मरदान एंड एन पिशार. और आप इससे अंदाज़ लगा सकते हैं कि जिस प्रोड्यूस से वो चंद हज़ार रुपये कमा सकते थे उससे उन्होंने 10 गुना ज़्यादा पैसे कमाना शुरू कर दिए. वी डिड अनदर पायलट इन गिलगित और पायलट में ये है कि आप ऑल तो यू हैव आप कभी कभार आप सक्सेसफुल नहीं भी रहते बट इवन देन हमने वी डिड अ प्रोजेक्ट फॉर 50 million रुपीज़ जिसमें से हमने क्या किया कि वी गैदर्ड अ ग्रुप ऑफ अराउंड 125 फार्मर्स और कैटल फार्मिंग हमने शुरू कराई उनसे कि जो ऑस्ट्रेलिया से दे इम्पोर्टेड देयर कैटल्स फ्रॉम वी सेंट ऑफ अ पर्सन फ्रॉम पिशार टू मेलबोर्न वहाँ पर उन्होंने सारी चीज़ें देख ली सेलेक्ट कर ली वेदर कंडीशन और वो सारी चीज़ें वो ला के हमने ट्रांसपोर्टेशन मरीन सारी वो देखने के बाद 120 कैटल्स वर शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम मेलबोर्न टू गिलगित. अब वहाँ पर हमने क्या किया वी प्रोवाइडेड लेडी फार्मर्स हु हैड द कैपेसिटी टू और हु हैड एन एक्स्ट्रा रूम इन दियर हाउस के जिसमें उनको अपने कैटल को रख सकें. हमने उनके लिए अरेंज कराया एक मिडल मैन जो कि इनको फॉडर और फीड प्रोवाइड करता था और उनसे मिल्क की कलेक्शन करके गिलगित के मार्केट्स में उन्होंने सप्लाई करना शुरू कर दिया. अब इमेजिन अ लेडी हु डज नॉट हैव एनीथिंग टू डू उनको हमने इनेबल किया कि अपार्ट फ्रॉम पेइंग द इंस्टॉलमेंट ऑफ द ऑन द कैटल उन्होंने खुद अपने घर के लिए अराउंड 15,000 रुपीस पर मंथ कमाना शुरू कर दिया. अब ये वो ख्वातीन हैं जिनको इस कॉन्सेप्ट का बिजनेस का भी नहीं पता था. इस सारे प्रोसेस में हमारे सामने ग्लिचेस भी आए बट we did incur a loss on a few occasions. कुछ उसमें से losses भी हमें आए but overall हमारा experience जो है सेटिस्फैक्टरी रहा. सिमिलरली हम अब एक प्रोजेक्ट के ऊपर काम कर रहे हैं जिसमें स्टार्टअप्स के लिए हम कॉन्सेप्ट स्टडी करेंगे. वी आर फैसिलिटेटिंग द KPK गवर्नमेंट फॉर दियर गवर्नमेंट इनिशिएटिव्स और जो वो लोन्स दे रहे हैं आप एक रिसेंट एग्जांपल कामयाब जवान जो प्राइम मिनिस्टर का है उसमें भी हम एक्सिक्यूटिंग एजेंसी हैं. एक और स्कीम KPK गवर्नमेंट की है फॉर द सेटल्ड डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स वहाँ पर हम एग्जीक्यूटिंग एजेंसीज हैं वहाँ पर हम एसेस करते हैं उनको पैसे देने के बाद मॉनिटरिंग करते हैं एंड वी डू प्रोवाइड हेल्प टू देम कि जी आप जहाँ जहाँ उनको कहीं पर ग्लिचेस आते हैं वी फैसिलिटेट देम एंड वी प्रोवाइड मार्केट एक्सेस टू देम नॉट रियली आरसेल्व्स बट वी फैसिलिटेट इन प्रोवाइडिंग मार्केट एक्सेस देम. सो बैंक को आजकल एक होलिस्टिक सोल्यूशन के तौर पर ही देखना चाहिए जो कि besides being the provider of money they also help in capacity building and providing training and all that.
Thank you, that was very insightful. Very happy to know of the case study as well. Ek aurat jisko pata hi nahi hai ki business ki itni knowledge nahi hai, know how nahi hai, and if she happens to raise 15,000 per month for a start, that too in a remote area, that is definitely something. I have taken the conversation forward. Aapse hi sawal hai mera. Is this similar to what Grameen Bank is doing in Bangladesh? Are we replicating jo unka micro loaning system hai? Are we doing that in Pakistan for our startups?
Well, Grameen Bank ka concept thoda sa different hai. Hum at our end, Pakistan mein jo microfinance ke jo institutions hain, wo to alaida ek sector hai. Finca hua, Tamir Microfinance ho gaya, and there are others. They're not they're practically payment systems now. In our case, humne ek microfinance ka ek division to banaya hua hai. और वो ऐसे पायरेट हम उनसे कराते रहते हैं बट बिसाइड्स दैट जब इनको कंपेयर करते हैं आप ग्रामीण से तो ग्रामीण का मॉडल बड़ा सिंपल सा था कि आपने वो ख्वातीन को ही पैसे देते थे बिकॉज दे थॉट दैट लेडीज आर जनरली बेटर दे आर मोर क्रेडिट वर्दी देन मैन इन आर केस हम बिजनेस सेटअप को देखते हैं और ये पायलट जो हमने जिसका मैंने जिक्र किया गिलगित में कि हमने गिलगित में किया उसमें ख्वातीन के पास वो कैपेसिटी थी वी कैपेसिटी थी कि वो परफॉर्म कर सकें कि वो काम कर सकें एंड दे वर विलिंग अच्छा इसमें एज आई मेंशन के जो हमें थोड़े से लॉसेस आना शुरू हो गए तो हमने ये भी अरेंज किया बिकॉज एज आई सेड वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग द हैंड होल्डिंग अपॉर्चुनिटी टू दिस पीपल कि जहाँ पर उनको डिफिकल्टी आ रही थी सम ऑफ द लेडीज हु वर नॉट बीइंग एबल टू कैरी ऑन विद देयर कैटल्स उनके लिए हमने नए फार्मर्स भी ढूंढे इन द नियर बाय लोकेलिटीज और हमने शिफ्ट भी कराए यू सी सो ग्रामीण बैंक वुड नॉट डू दिस थिंग इन आर केस वी डिड मोर इम्पोर्टेंटली अभी हमारे दोस्त बात कर रहे थे कि जी जब कोई नया स्टार्टअप फाइनेंसिंग मिलती नहीं है एट द बैंक ऑफ खैबर व्हेन आई लुक एट माय पोर्टफोलियो ओनली 25% ऑफ माय पोर्टफोलियो in the KPK is focused towards corporates. Around 79% of my portfolio is in the SME sector. And I have seen one phenomena in the banking sector when it comes to KPK. It's that the banking sector or other banks are generally shy in terms of providing credit to the people here. We being local and aware of the business environment and the culture, we have been aggressive. Although we do take collateral, aisa nahi hai ki hum collateral nahi lete, jahan jahan possible hota hai. We collateral lete hain, bagair collateral ki bhi lete hain, jo small loan, micro credit jahan par hota hai. वो आपको केपी में बैंक ऑफ खैबर के अलावा बहुत कम मिलेंगे कि जी किसी बैंक ने एग्रेसिवली परसू किया है हम इसको भी देख रहे हैं कि जो मोमन एजेंसी में फॉर एग्जांपल ज़ियारत का एक एरिया है मार्बल का वहाँ हम कैसे उन लोगों को फैसिलिटेट कर सकते हैं तो कि जी जो ब्लास्ट करते हैं बहुत सारा अच्छा आपका काफ़ी बेहतर क्वालिटी का आपका स्टोन ज़ाया हो जाता है उसको कटिंग में कैसे ले आए ताकि वो ज़ाया ना हो हम इसको भी देखते हैं कि जी आपका अगर सवाद के एरिया में कुछ ख़ास फ्रूट अगर अवेलेबल है उसको कैसे चैनलन किया जाए कि वो कराची के मार्केट पहुंच के बेहतर प्राइस आपको दे सके सो यू सी हियरिंग दिस फ्रॉम अ बैंकर प्रॉब्ली इज एन एलियन थिंग बट वी डू दैट
दैट्स ग्रेट टॉकिंग अबाउट या एब्सोल्युटली प्लीज
द बिगेस्ट एडवांटेज परहैप्स दिस इज देयर इन ऑल प्रोविंसेस बट एज फार एज खैबर पख्तूनख्वा इज दैट the government owns a large part of Bank of Khyber. So if there's an initiative that the government, especially, you know, what are the key initiatives of this government? Poverty alleviation, socio-economic development, women empowerment, perhaps. So if those are initiatives from the government side, the Bank of Khyber supports that. Yeah. I've seen, having traveled and met with the academia, and we had lengthy discussions when we were crafting this long-term plan for CPAC about utilizing our human resource. The biggest, because they were amazed, and when they traveled and did some research, they were amazed the kind of human resource we have. They're quite capable. They can speak English, which is A in demand as far as international businesses are concerned. The problem that came as far as the schemes that we have and also as far as the, you know, academic output is concerned, perhaps was the efficiency. And I agree to my friend sitting here, that cannot be, you know, inculcated in a person when he comes at a higher education institution. It has to start from perhaps at the grassroots level, and more so at least perhaps at a parental level, which we all are. So the biggest difference I've seen in human resource is the efficiency part. Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, ladies and gentlemen, enjoys the biggest advantage of political stability. And this is, as far as entrepreneurs are concerned, and also as far as business activities concerned, I think supports us the most.
Thank you. That was a very valuable insight, which actually springs two more questions, one for the academia and one for the incubation centers. I'll start with the incubation centers first over here. There was a conversation right now about more financial inclusion through the banks. And I'd like to divert this question towards you, Faisal. Can you please tell me the roles of incubation centers, I mean, you foreseeing in terms of the NIC, in ensuring inclusion as far as fundraising practices are concerned? Because I just like to make a note over here. So when you start a business, either you need money for expansion, but that's phase number two. A lot of startup ideas, they need to invest initially because research is involved, or if there's hardware and technology that's involved. Faisal.
Yeah, so every business needs some money to extend their runway. That's needed for them to verify whether there is a product market fit, there is a customer validation. So they need this money. And of course, the first option they do is this, they look around. Their own money, asking their friends and families to pull in. But that's very limited amount, all right? So then they reach out, all right? So what the role of incubator is that they need to prepare. They need to be very clear on what they're going to do with that amount of money. That's one thing that we help them. Then the other thing is to connect them with the people who have access to funds. Whoever is investing. Now, there's with Karachi and Peshawar, there's a different. In Peshawar, what I've noticed is that there are local individuals who have lots of money, right? That's right. And they are no longer interested in investing in building another plaza or buying another plot. So they now appreciate that it takes patience to get some good returns in a technology-led startup. All right. So NIC is creating that awareness both for the startups and for the potential investors as well. And that opportunity is open to everyone. So you can just, I don't know if all you are aware that NIC is an open facility. Anyone can just walk in. You can walk in as an investor. You can walk in as someone who has potential idea. So if you're walking as an investor, you can demand us, yeah, I want to see your startups. I want to know the opportunities I have as an investor to invest. Right, and it's our responsibility to connect you with the like-minded startups as well.
Thank you, Faisal. Moving back to the academia, you know, there was a conversation by our fellow panelists over here about efficiency, you know, and about the difference in human resources, and that, you know, starting from the very grassroots level, entrepreneurship starts from grassroots level. We have to ensure inclusion. And when you talk about the grassroots level, let's also try to understand one thing. Things that probably even incubation centers previously missed out on, but Telenor Velocity started with it when last year they had a cohort that revolved around solutions for agriculture, because hamari jo jo produce hai zyada wo agrarian economy hai, we cannot negate that. So coming back to the grassroots, right, and talking about entrepreneurship and starting from the very basic level, I mean, there's a high need for entrepreneurship in the lower level for, you know, for, of course, to have more SMEs and business structures. What do you foresee, I mean, keeping all the factors that you talked about, that we need help from the government, we need help from all the other sectors, but keeping all other factors constant, what is the academia doing right now? And secondly, where do you see yourself, let's say, in the short term, 5 years down the road, and then in the long term?
The point is that the academia plays definitely the basic role, because the entrepreneurship requires the human input. So that comes from the academia side, definitely. So as my colleague mentioned, that it has to be from the grassroots level. So if we keep all the other things constant for this discussion purpose, which it's very hard to do in practice, but for this discussion, obviously. So definitely the academia has to come up with the syllabus structures, right? Skills-based qualification. And we have to move from some traditional type of studies as well. Like I always tell my other students and some government institutions that I come across that we are studying one statistics book probably from the 1980s, and it is still going on today. They are still using that one book. So there is no change in that. The syllabus has rarely been changed. So we have to come up with syllabus changes, basic changes, introduce entrepreneurship studies at government level as well, because most of the input is at the villages level, the schools and the government colleges. So professional colleges are only up to the cities. So the government has to come up with syllabus, and they have to provide these qualifications which are skills-based. So that will definitely make a change.
अगर देखा जाए, मैं एक बहुत common एक लव्स उर्दू की ज़बान में इस्तेमाल होता है जुगाड़. तो हम तो इस चीज़ में बहुत माहिर हैं. बच्चा बच्चा गली गली में उसके टायर पंक्चर हो जाए. He knows how to make his way around it. It's and it has been named as 10x thinking, moonshot thinking. इनको टर्म्स दे दिए गए हैं. So I mean the skill, the idea is there. What is not happening right now in academia besides the curriculum? Because curriculum is one thing, right?
Yeah, then we have to bring all the factors back in, right? Because then if we just put, as you said, that the jugaad thing, that's not going to work in the long term. It's probably going to work in the short term, but in the long term, that's not going to work. So we have to, any strategy that we have to come up with, we have to come up with a long-term strategy, even if it's a government. Short term doesn't work for economic growth. So if we are talking especially about education, we have to think very long term. We are trying to develop intellectual capital, and intellectual capital you cannot develop in probably 1 to 5 years. We'll have to input the syllabus, the people, the relevant people, the skills, the teachers, all of the setups. So like as we are discussing, when we are talking about the entrepreneurship ecosystem, then ecosystem means involving all the stakeholders. In that equation, like we cannot keep the teachers out of it, we cannot keep the government out of it. So only sticking to the academia, even that has its own stakeholders. So we have to come up with a proper system. We cannot just focus on one thing or a student or only the syllabus. Again, we have to come up with a proper education ecosystem for the designed specifically for the entrepreneurship. So then probably
absolutely similar. And the next question is for you then.
Adding one point to it, appreciating this thing, the UET Peshawar, I've heard there, although it's an engineering university, but they have come up with a diploma course in gemology, and many people who know about this thing, they have enrolled and they have successfully qualified. And I know a few people who have not only started that emerald business, but have also started to grade their emeralds. Or abhi next phase mein aise log main logon ko main janta hu jo ke emeralds ko leke cut kara ke Thailand leke ja rahe hain. And amazingly, a person who not have any money 4 months ago crowdfunded his business from his friends and relatives by 400,000 rupees. He is taking an inventory or stock of around 5 million rupees to Thailand. So it's just a period of just 4 months' time. And there is, as you were saying, the academia, the engineering university, Peshawar, it provided opportunity to him, although he's an engineer himself, but he opted for that gemology since he had some free time. And that gemology is now giving him better opportunity of doing business than his engineering background.
Thank you for yes, please.
You see, in the ecosystem, and please do not take me in a wrong way, in an ecosystem where you do not have corrupt practices, even jugaad works. Okay. Like for instance, agar hum say, let's take example of 80s ka China. So agar wo ye sochte hai ki jugaad system pe kaam na karein, and I hope this is not taken in the way that I'm, you know, it should be taken in the essence, please. Silicon Valley may, you know, the biggest of ideas and the smartest of smartest people in the 80s and then later in the 90s, AI technology pe kaam kar rahe the. What they did was ke har Shenzhen and Guangzhou, and some of you have been there, must would know, ke wahan par ab har ghar mein Apple ke products ka koi na koi part ban raha hai, kahin ko cover ban raha hai, kahin koi headphones ban rahe hain, because they realize that how the global supply chain or many, and please remember this is place where, you know, per capita people speaking English is much less than what we have, you know, their understanding of the international ways of doing business in 80s that I'm saying, jab main pehli dafa gaya to wahan pe to, you know, it was even difficult for me to find ways. It all happened after Olympics in Beijing. So जुगाड़ होना वो इतना गलत बात नहीं है, उसको करप्ट प्रैक्टिसेस को आप निकाल दें, आप देखें कि इस ग्लोबल सप्लाई चेन में या एटलीस्ट रीजनल सप्लाई चेन में आप कहाँ फिट इन होते हैं. सर ने मेंशन किया माइंस एंड मिनरल्स का, देयर अदर प्लेसेस वेयर वी हैव दिस नेचुरल एंडाउमेंट, आप उसको लिंक करें. अब मैं आपको एग्जाम्पल एक लास्ट दे देता हूँ, आई विल जस्ट नॉट बॉदर यू मोर विद दैट. इस वक्त चाइना के अंदर विद इन डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड प्रोविंस the biggest competition is ke who produces more AI based products, aur jiska mayor zyada produce karta hai usko, you know, he gets promotion. Similarly within universities, patent kaun zyada karta hai aur kaun naye products banata hai. Dekhen aapke pichle question mein aapne kaha ke should we produce A graders. Yes, we need A graders. A graders would always be there, there would always be people who looking to get the top slot position. Sirf humne academia mein shayad ye karna hai ke we should tell our entrepreneurs, I think ye bahut acha kaam kar rahe hain, aise wale, lekin overall, you know, we have so many private and public universities. I think we should teach them to be different. Top perhaps that has to do with finance, agar paise mil gaye to shayad, but agar aap thoda sa apne andar difference layenge to fir AI bhi aa jaye, robots bhi aa jaye, perhaps they would not impact you more. Or hamare paas as a less developed country, I think this is area where we should find. Best part again for KP, as I said earlier, perhaps was that we have pockets, sir ne bhi mentioned kiya, I think we have people who are ready to invest in this. There are pockets of venture capital jisse jo entrepreneurial cycle hai, I think usko support milta hai. But what you have to do is, even if you go for jugaad, just look at the right jugaad and look at the right kind of best practice that would help you in going towards it, perhaps.
Thank you for your valuable input. And the next question is actually directed towards you, and CPEC in particular is another, it's a gateway to China and a road towards opportunity. And how do you think has CPEC impacted, you know, in terms of opening more ventures around startups, more opportunities for SMEs? How are you ensuring their participation? What is happening in this space?
In an academic sense, let's talk it in an academic sense and then perhaps in a sure, business sense. Sure. In an academic sense, competition, and also in business sense perhaps, competition always helps. Because when you work with the second best economy in the world, you realize the gap. And then at a government level perhaps, and also at academia level, and also at incubation center level, we try to bridge that gap. The competition would be there. As I said earlier, there is no boundary for human resource, there is no boundary for investment. All we have to do is create the enabling environment. So in that, perhaps the best thing, because I represent academia also, best thing that has done is us to realize our weaknesses. Because Chinese invest a lot in their R&D, universities are doing profoundly well, and they look at perhaps the West as, so now while we look at West, we also should look at China. What we've done in CPEC is that we've built this consortium of business school. IIM Sciences is part of it. 10 top business school from Pakistan, doing and 5 top business school from China, and they're doing research for for CPEC. So we give them an area to research and they should produce this good quality stuff. Also at HEC level, there is a university to university alliance being built. Lekin jaisa maine pehle kaha, I think we have a lot of ideas. I think we have a lot of policies that the government, we have our finance minister also here and he would speak about it. The only thing that we need to do is synergize. CPEC is good. CPEC creates opportunities. We are linking ourselves to the second largest economy. I believe, and this is my belief, at least till the time that I'm in this planet, China will remain the factory of the world. Say 2050 or perhaps a little beyond. I do not see any other country having the kind of supply chain mechanism or so why not we become the part of their supply chain, look at areas where we can produce more, including human resource, and perhaps export to China and create the joint ventures. And the government at its level is doing its best, even in Russia, and I think we have Dr. Ali sitting right at the back. We're creating that environment where we can have these joint ventures, where even if an enterprise is coming, it should come with new technology. And if they bring new technology, employ more human resource, they'll get more incentives for that.
And do you also feel the need to have like a stronger connect between all these sectors? Because, you know, we have the banking sector over here, but then we have the incubation space today, the academia. When everybody talks about opportunities, we also have to maneuver together, as rightly pointed out by people hailing from the academia over here.
I think we should work on the triple helix model, where we should have academia, we should have government, we should have industry. And I think the incubation center are right platform for that triple helix model. The government and the industry should actually indicate, we have ORIX in almost all universities, and we should ask them, give them research. May I give you an example?
Please, on a negative note,
usually you should not finish on a negative note. When I was working in CPEC, to many HEC and all the universities, quick letter likha on the areas for second phase of CPEC, that these are the areas where we want to do research on. But unfortunately, the reply I got was only from public sector universities, because perhaps they knew that they are answerable to the government. So private sector universities, I think, should also get involved in R&D. And on this, I think we should thank ACCA also, because they are encouraging this kind of debate. We have the government leaders here.
Sure. Perhaps, yeah. Thank you for that. My next question revolves around something that has been a pain for many startups, but it's related to the banking sector. You know, when you talk about payments, a lot of startups are concerned about digital payments, easier financial inclusion. My first question would be about, the future of, crowdfunding in Pakistan, because that's another thing that early stage companies are really looking forward to, rather than, taking loans from a bank. And secondly, the format of digital payments and how banks are actually playing a role in that.
Crowdfunding, it's a preliminary stage here in Pakistan specifically. Although people are a bit, थोड़ा सा इनके यहाँ पर ये भी है कि जी बैंक के पास जाएंगे तो कोलेटरल वाली बात आ गई या जो दूसरी सफिस्टिकेशन वाली बात आ गई तो यू डू रिवर्ट टू फ्रेंड्स एंड फैमिली एंड यू टेक फंडिंग फ्रॉम देयर हाउएवर हैविंग सेड दैट वहाँ पर थोड़ा सा एक इशू ये आया है ऑन मैनी ओकेजन्स के इन परसूट ऑफ हायर रिटर्न पीपल हैव लॉस्ट देयर मनी एंड दैट हैज़ बिकम अ डिटरेंट इन रेजिंग कैपिटल इन द फॉर्म ऑफ क्राउड फंडिंग but the realization is growing and as businesses are taking shape, people are providing financing to them. As far as digital payments are concerned, that is the future. Every bank these days is trying to firm up arrangements with fintech companies for making payments digitally for all their customers, so much so कि हम आजकल इस एंगल के ऊपर सोच रहे हैं कि जो डिफरेंट गवर्नमेंट इनिशिएटिव्स जो हमने एग्जीक्यूट किए हैं उसमें बहुत सारे देही इलाकों में हैं एंड वी आर थिंकिंग कि हम किसी के साथ हो सकता है कि कोऑर्डिनेट कर लें और उनके चैनल को यूज़ करते हुए जो रीपेमेंट है वो हमें उनसे ही आए. फॉर एग्जांपल इजी पैसा हुआ जो जिसका मैंने कुछ देर पहले जिक्र किया. And in the meantime, we are developing our own app and we are deploying our own technology. Jab hamari apni capacity build ho jayegi to make payments digitally for all our customers. Filhal, digital payments form only 6% of the entire transactions. Jisme capacity hai ke aap with slight innovation and awareness and security features because aapke agar firewalls proper na ho to aapke bahut sare resources ya for that matter customer ke balances jo hai disturb ho sakte hain. There could be tremendous operational loss with some tweaking aap usko kafi aage ke level tak leke ja sakte hain.
Thank you.
I'll just add to it to the good news.
Sure.
SACCA ne first draft of crowdsource funding release kar diya. So it's good news that the government is working towards that and inshallah soon we will have the results.
I think that is brilliant news for everybody sitting over here, all the listed companies. Faisal, my last question would be for you and then we can wrap up the conversation. A very important thing when you talk about inclusion and inclusion is not just in terms of different sectors, but it's also in relation to gender parity. It's also in relation to interfaith harmony. What are the role that incubation centers are, presenting over here?
So by design, these incubation centers are meant to be open for everyone. As I said in the beginning, regardless of your gender, regardless of your religion, regardless of your status in the economy, they're open. Unfortunately, the numbers are not that encouraging. If I give you the example of NIC Peshawar, so far the percentage of female founders is only 11%. That's very, very low. The good news is that of all the investment NIC Peshawar has raised in past 2 years, 60% of that went to female-led startup. But that shows that the investors are more confident in those businesses. If I take example of NIC Karachi, I have a diversified portfolio of founders. We have people from Hindu community, we have people from the Christian community. In Peshawar, we're not that diversified. So that means either we're not reaching out to them, more effectively, we need to do a good job. But the message needs to go out to everywhere. Yesterday, my team was there at the Shaheed Benazir Bhutto University, sending out the same message that this facility is available, it's open, the infrastructure is there. It's a safe working environment for women and a happy place to be. A few initiatives we need to take care of. For example, we need to set up a daycare center at the facility. So that will open up access to more potential entrepreneurs.
I think that's a brilliant idea and I wish you the very best of luck with that. That would actually allow a lot of working mothers to, make mothers working mothers and allow them to actually work on their ideas, work on their startups while the child is also there. Thank you, Faisal, for your valuable input. I would like to conclude this panel discussion by a few of the key points that I identified, and I'm sure you all will agree to that all sectors, number one, need to work in harmony. We need a lot to be done as far as the academia is concerned. My personal take is that we can start with simple bake sales. If you don't have a fancy curriculum or if the curriculum has not really been worked upon and probably even need to polish the skills of the people hailing from the academia sector who are teaching in the classroom, because the classroom learning has to be very stimulative. So inclusion has to be across sectors. We're so happy to have the Bank of Khyber here with us because without the support of local banks, the startups or the SME sector cannot flourish, will not flourish. And I see a lot of collaboration opportunities probably when we all sit down over the networking session for tea. We can all collaborate and think of, and synergize our ideas for that matter. Very happy to have representation from the CPEC as well. Thank you so much, everyone. We'll be happy to take questions if there are any. Can you also please introduce yourself and also mention who the question is addressed for?
Malik Paracha, I'm representing Bank Islami here. So while hearing about NICs, the incubation centers, question came across my mind. What about incubation? I mean, can you tell us out of these incubation centers, how many ideas have translated into startup businesses and any notable names of these startups? The second part of my question is to the academians. Do you guys really think can we teach entrepreneurship? Because the leading thinkers of our time and presently in the developing country, they don't think that we can teach entrepreneurships. For if you want to foster entrepreneurship, probably you will have to go to work around the person from BOK was talking about UET. They have channelized a gemstone a diploma program from where people who really wanted to start up businesses, they came out and they are being successful now. So, I mean, the students going to conventional studies, are they good material for entrepreneurships? I mean, I have a question there as well. First incubation.
I can provide you a very quick answer. So one success story is right here. Bera, you see the logo. Jahangir was the founder. He was here somewhere. It's a premium brand for apparel. That's a story coming out of NIC Peshawar. The Revro is a household name here in Peshawar. Last mile delivery services is a success story of NIC Peshawar. Bikeya, another emerging startup that came out of our NIC Karachi. So, and there are a few more as well. I will encourage you to go to our website and see the list of startups that actually made an impact on the economy of the country.
Teaching entrepreneurship through a conventional mode of education.
See, we are talking about entrepreneurship and we are living in a country which do not even offer business as a subject at matriculate level and intermediate level. Aap jab bachcho ko matriculate level or intermediate level pe business ko as a subject hi offer nahi kar. Business sense hai, business acumen hai, wo develop hi nahi ho sakta. Aap bilkul theek keh rahe hain ki leadership skills bilkul har waqt sikhaye nahi ja sakte, innovation nahi sikhai ja sakti. Lekin sir, har business ki kuch basics hain. आप जब बच्चे को ग्रास रूट लेवल से लेके आओगे, उसे बिजनेस एज अ सब्जेक्ट पढ़ाओगे, अभी बच्चा बायो लैब में जाता है, फिजिक्स की लैब्स में जाता है, अगर उसे स्कूल लेवल पे, कॉलेज लेवल पे बिजनेस मॉडल्स बनवाए जाएंगे, वहाँ पे आइडिया पिचिंग करवाई जाएगी, तो उस बच्चे में एटलीस्ट बिजनेस सेंस और बिजनेस इक्विपमेंट डेवलप होना स्टार्ट हो जाएगा. सो जहाँ पे आप बात करते हैं कि जी एंटरप्रेन्योर स्किल सिखाए नहीं जा सकते, सर बेसिक सिखाई जा सकती है. हर बिजनेस के एक सेंस है, बिजनेस इक्विपमेंट है, उसकी एक बेसिस है, वो वहीं से स्टार्ट होंगी. आपकी जो पॉपुलेशन है सर, अगर आप केपी की बात करते हैं, अगर एक साल में 1,00,000 बच्चा एफएससी करता है, उसका 60% जो है वो शायद मेडिकल के इंट्री टेस्ट में बैठ जाता है, फॉर 20,000 इंजीनियरिंग के इंट्री टेस्ट में बैठ जाता है. अब हाफ से ज़्यादा बच्चा आपका एक ऐसे इंट्री टेस्ट में बैठ गया जिसमें सिर्फ उसके 2% या 3% चांसेस ऑफ सक्सेस है. अब वो बच्चा जब यूनिवर्सिटीज़ में आता है, उसका वो माइंड सेट ही नहीं होता बिजनेस वाला. आपने जब बिजनेस करना है, आपको करेज भी चाहिए, आपको बिजनेस सेंस भी चाहिए, आपको फाइनेंसिस भी चाहिए, लेकिन जब आप बेसिक लेवल पे एलिमेंट्री एजुकेशन, हायर एंड सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन लेवल पे बिजनेस को एज अ सब्जेक्ट इंट्रोड्यूस करोगे, तब बच्चे में इंटरेस्ट डेवलप होगा, और जिस चीज़ में उसको इंटरेस्ट होगा वो फ्यूचर में जाके वो जरूर करना चाहेगा.
आई थिंक आई कैन बिकॉज आई वर्क्ड इन ऑल पार्ट ऑफ पाकिस्तान. खैबर पख्तूनख्वा, आई थिंक ह्यूमन रिसोर्स हैज अ गिफ्टेड नैक ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस. Even if you go to China and if you go to a city called Iwu, you would find more people from Khyber Pakhtunkhwa than anywhere else from the world. So, ek to khuda ne ek khudadad salahiyat di hai for you to actually become entrepreneurs. What you know the academic cycle could do is A, to teach you best practices, because that you need to know. Aap say mines and minerals mein aap you know information you know sharing hoti rahe, and but you need value addition, you need new practices to come. Ek to ye आपकी बात इस लिहाज से मैं दुरुस्त समझता हूँ कि our academic system is perhaps geared towards jobs. हमारे मुल्क के अंदर अब मेडिकल की अगर आप बात करें तो मेडिकल डॉक्टर्स CSS का इम्तिहान दे के पक्की नौकरी की तलाश में भी जाते हैं. सो यू कांट यू नो यू यू कैन नॉट से के द सिस्टम इज़ बैड और द सिस्टम इज़ गुड. आई थिंक कि गवर्नमेंट की जो पॉलिसीज़ हैं और जो मोस्ट रिसेंटली वो बहुत ज़्यादा सपोर्ट कर रही हैं एंटरप्रेन्योरल साइकिल को. द काइंड ऑफ इंसेंटिव्स दी आप अगर आज जाएं और बैंक ऑफ खैबर की या स्टेट बैंक की सिर्फ जो पॉलिसीज टुवर्ड्स एंटरप्रेन्योरल वर्क टुवर्ड्स कॉटेज इंडस्ट्री टुवर्ड्स SME सेक्टर है आप हैरान हो जाएंगे कि कितने इंसेंटिव दिए जा रहे हैं एक्सेस टू फाइनेंसिंग कितनी जा रही है. बहुत सारी चीज़ें हमारी मिथ पे होती हैं कि जी कोलेट्रल नहीं होगा हमसे क्वेश्चंस होंगे और एज अपोज टू दैट आई थिंक द बैंक्स आर लुकिंग फॉर पीपल टू कम एंड यू नो बट नेचुरली वी हैव दीज रेगुलेटरी reforms being undertaken, we have FATF and other things happening around us. सिर्फ ये है कि बहुत सारी चीज़ें मिथ पे भी चल रही होती हैं जी हमें नहीं मिलेगा लोन नहीं मिल आप बैंक में एक दफ़ा कदम तो रखें इंशाल्लाह आपको बड़ा कुछ मिलेगा.
वैसे जो मिथ वाली बात है ज़्यादा सही है और इन आर केस दैट इज इन द केस ऑफ KPK द गवर्नमेंट इज रियली मोर responsive and facilitating. चार पांच funds इसी government ने बनाए हैं जिसमें आपको बग़ैर collateral के पैसे मिल जाते हैं significant ease से पैसे मिल जाते हैं. आपको सिर्फ ये प्रूफ करना है कि आपके पास एक worthwhile idea है and you are serious enough. Generally speaking, I have also seen एक तो लोग एक नहीं मिलेगा but एक और एलिमेंट ये भी है कि जो लोग आते हैं ना उनके जहन में ये भी होता है कि जी ये मुफ्त के पैसे मिल रहे हैं वापस नहीं करने तो इनको बताना पड़ता है कि जी आप पैसे लें कारोबार करें हम आपको ग्रेजुएट कराएंगे नेक्स्ट लेवल तक हम आपको आप छोटे से शुरू करें हम आपको स्मॉल बनाएंगे स्मॉल से फिर आपको मीडियम में लेके जाएंगे. वहाँ से भी थोड़े से लोग निकल जाते हैं उस स्पेक्ट्रम से जिनको हम फैसिलिटेट करना चाहते हैं.
Thank you so much. Thank you to all the listeners as well, the participants. We're running a little short on time, so we'll have to wind up this panel discussion. I'd like to thank all the panelists for coming, for taking time out today, and having a very enlightening discussion. Thank you, everyone.